Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist here at American RV in gorgeous Grand Rapids, Michigan. Today I'm here to tell you all about the 2017 Shasta Revere 33BH. This is a large bunkhouse travel trailer, huge ceilings inside. But let's go ahead and start up front here. We'll make our way around and then head on in. So one of the first things you'll notice is this right here, which is your propane tank cover. Nice and easy to access the tanks. Just undo the thumb screws. That will lift the door up and will give you access to your two 30-pound propane tanks right there. Also, if you take a look over here, you will see a light. So if you do have to hook up or disconnect at night, go ahead and turn that guy on for some added visibility. Right up front here is diamond plating. The diamond plating comes up nice and high on this coach, which is great. That helps protect the front ends from any rocks or debris that get thrown up by the tow vehicle. Then in between the diamond plate here and your propane tank are rails for your batteries. Then move around to the side here. This, of course, is the pass-through storage. You do have a covered hinge there, so it won't rust out on you. Then if you take a look, you can see nice big opening here. There's good storage area. You do have another access point underneath the bed, so you can go ahead and lift the bed up and get to it from that side as well. As we make our way back a little bit further, you will notice right here two electrical outlets. They are individual, so that way if you need to plug anything in, you can certainly go ahead and do that. Large power awning on this coach. This does go over the kitchen slide area, so it goes all the way back there, which is great. So just touch a button, rolls out, touch of a button, rolls back in. And sewn into the material itself is an LED light. So that way, whether you have it out, you know, just a little bit or fully extended, you will have those LED lights shining down on your campsite. Then three steps to get in. Also you have the easy grab handle here too. So this does fold to put it away, but this of course will help you from the first step all the way to the last step, just to make sure that you're not gonna slip and fall. So that's definitely a nice added feature. On the slide out itself, if you take a look up at the corners, you will see two outside speakers. That way if you wanna sit out here, listen to music, you can certainly do that. Now those speakers are controlled by the multimedia center inside, however it is Bluetooth capable. So that way if you want to sit out here, use your smartphone or tablet, be able to connect to that via Bluetooth, and then you can operate all your music from right out here. Let's take a look underneath real quick. You will notice that these axles do sit a little bit further apart than most. That's because it's a spread axle system. That helps reduce the sway on there. Also, nitrogen filled tires, which will give you a smoother ride, a little bit better gas mileage, and easy lube axles on there as well. So that will help you on the maintenance side of things further down the road. Then right where this awning ends starts the outside kitchen. One of my favorite part about bunkhouses is this right here. You get the big, beautiful outside kitchen. You can see you have excellent cupboard space right up top here. This one right there does have a shelf as well, so you can go ahead and divide if you want to put, you know, cups up there or spices, whatever you want. You have TV hookup out here as well if you want to hook up the TV. A light too, so if you want to go ahead and flip that, you have an LED light right there. This is your fridge, so you can go ahead, open that guy up. That has a very perfect place, plenty of room for all your condiments, beverages, all that good stuff. Then underneath here, you'll see two drawers there and a flip down tray right here in the center. Now, I know what you're thinking. They call this an outside kitchen. Where do you cook at? Not a problem either. If you come right back here, you will notice they have an arm. On this arm mounts a grill. Then right underneath, you have a propane quick connect, so you can just go ahead and hook that grill right up. That way it feeds off your 60 pounds of propane up front. Also, right located back here is your outside shower. I love that they put it here. It's very easy to access. That does have both hot and cold. So that way if you need to, you know, wash off fish or your feet or wash the dog, whatever it may be, it is nice and easy to get to right there. All right, that'll wrap it up for the outside. Let's go take a look at the inside. Welcome to the inside of the 2017 Shasta Revere 33BH. This particular model is in the chocolate chip interior. One of my favorite things about the Revere line is the height of the ceiling and the height of the slides. Take a look at this beautiful 7-foot tray ceiling. You have a ton of headspace here, so you don't feel like you're cramped or claustrophobic. Beautiful skylight there as well. Lets in a lot of natural light during the day, and you have LEDs all the way around at night. But let's go ahead and move over here for a second. One of my other features that I like about this particular floor plan, as soon as you walk in, right here's a coat closet. I love when manufacturers do this. You know, a lot of times when I'm camping, it's a little bit later, it's fall. I like to be able to just come in, take my sweatshirt or jacket off, hang it up right there, nice and convenient. Place for hats up top and a little space down here. You know, if you wanna put shoes there, you can do that, or really whatever else you want to. But I just like that they went ahead and put that in. And as you move in a little bit further, you kind of have a dual purpose. You kind of move into the kitchen, but right over here is your entertainment area. So if you notice, there's a sticker right here for where you put that TV backer. You do have your cables running from your multimedia center because this is a radio, CD, and DVD player. So if you want to watch a movie, you can go ahead and pop it in and watch it on the TV. But the other thing I like about this space is if you don't want a TV, you know, not everyone watches TV when they go camping, you can just push this cord back down, hide it, put some trinkets here, you know, put a picture or something up here, and it just becomes another beautiful space. It's not like a huge dedicated entertainment center like you see in a lot of travel trailers. But again, if you do want it, it is certainly there and available for use. And as I mentioned, we were outside. This is that multimedia center that runs the speakers outside as well as in here. Then up top here, you have some additional storage. You can see right up there, cubby holes beneath the multimedia center, and a great additional storage right under there. Then because you have big dual opposing slides, that allows for a central island here. So this gives you great prep space. You know, you have some on each side of the sink, and they also give you the sink top covers to help utilize that as prep space as well. Now both these sink top covers can be used as cutting boards. My recommendation, if you do, make sure you use the same side every time. That way all the knife marks are on one side. So when you're done, you can flip it back over and then no one will see the knife marks. But double bowl sink there, high rise pull out faucet makes it nice and easy to go ahead and wash and rinse dishes. Now not only do you have prep space, but underneath you have a lot of great storage. You can see right here, bank of four full extension ball bearing drawers on there. And then underneath you have some additional storage there. Then back over across the way, this is the Dometic fridge freezer combo. Open that up for you, 8 cubic foot. This one does run off of both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. So what that means for you is if you are running it off propane, as soon as you plug it into electric, it will automatically switch over for you, saving you on your propane gas. Then if you take a look up top here, this is the microwave. This is the weight of the unit, 8,513 pounds. A little bit of extra storage right to the side. They do have a shelf built in there as well, which is cool. Right here, of course, your fully functional hood with the light and the fan, and as it should be, that is right above your Atwood 3-burner cooktop. Front one on there is high output, great flame control on the Atwood, and then underneath you have an oven if you want to do a little baking. Now you do have an electrical outlet here as well, so my opinion, this is a perfect spot for your little coffee bar. You know, put your Keurig there, whatever you have, just a great, great area for it. Then right down here, again, you have a bank of three full extension drawers, a little bit longer than what's in the island. So if you have larger items like you know, big spatulas, serving spoons, things like that, you can put them over there. And then underneath here is a deeper drawer, so a good place for some pots and pans. But we're not done yet. Take a look right over here. If you want some extra storage, this has great extra storage right here. You can see there, lots of great cutouts, perfect pantry space. You know, you can fit a lot of chips in there, cereal, whatever else you want to bring with you. But again, just excellent pantry space on the side. As we make our way into the bunk room of the 33BH, one of the things I like to point out is the doors in the Revere. They have this beautiful white designer style door, and look how tall it is. You know, that's an actual door right there. It's not a curtain like you see that a lot of manufacturers use. Then as you move over to the side, this right here is a slide out. You have a bunk right up top here. Now this does lift up. You'll see it's strut supported, so it is very easy to raise. That way it gives room for the kids to sit down on the cube couch here. Also, this cube does fold out into a bed, very easy. The thing I like about this is if you have taller children, this makes into a very large bed. So if they don't fit on the bunks, they will certainly fit on the cube there. Window down below as well lets in a lot of natural light during the day. Another window right here on the back, and you have some additional storage. You'll see a hanging rod right up top there, storage area up top above that, and then two drawers right down below. Then over here, this of course is above the outside kitchen. This is your third bunk, teddy bear bunk series, I may add, so it is very soft. That way the kids will get a good night's sleep. Built-in ladder, so it is nice and easy to climb up. Then if you notice, behind the ladder you have additional shelving, so you can go ahead and store stuff behind the ladder as well. Then a cutout area right here for a TV, so if you want to, again, if you do want a TV back here, you can have one. Otherwise, you can put whatever you want there. Cutout down below, and then additional storage right there. So on the off-door side, this right here is the super slide. What I wanted to show the table down. Normally most of my videos I show them up, but I just wanted to show you how quick and easy it is to make up a U-dinette bed and how much space you actually get. So what I did do is I went ahead and removed the legs. I dropped the table down. You'll see there's rails right here, and the table just sits right on those rails. Then what you do, it actually comes with an extra cushion, this one right here. So you kind of stick this guy in there, just like so, and then you take this cushion, stuff this guy in there, and there you have it. Nice large bed. And then if you take these out, and same thing on the other side, I mean, look how large this bed is. You can easily sleep two full adults on here. You know, and personally, I think that's probably the biggest advantage of having the U-dinette is how big of a bed it makes up. Of course, the other advantage is that it does give you a little bit more space to go ahead and sit around. That way, if you need to play a game together, have a meal together, whatever you want to do, it is nice and easy to do so. Another feature, you will notice on the sections I took out here in the corners, they do have cup holders there, which is pretty neat. Big windows all the way around, let in a lot of natural light. You have a light here as well, and then a wall sconce too. And if you take a look underneath, it is very easy to access the storage. You don't have to lift the cushions up and off, just drop the door down, and you can access the storage right there under the dinette. And as you move over, this will get us into the couch. Again, you have windows here. This couch is very comfortable to sit on too. This is a jackknife style sofa, so you can see right here, this is pretty cool, how much storage there is down there. So this does lift up and drop down into a bed. But the other cool thing about this one, take a look at that. How easy is that to get to storage? That's one of the biggest advantages of having a jackknife sofa, is you get all the storage underneath. You can put bedding down there, you know, your sheets, your blankets, or again, whatever else you want. But I love the fact that they made it very easy to get to. Then you have additional storage right up here up top. They kind of have the decorative glass up there, but you can see the space right up there. The other thing I want you to take note of is look how tall the slides are. This is a travel trailer. Again, I'm about 6 foot. I can stand underneath these slides. I don't hit my head like I do on a lot of them. So, you know, you have taller ceilings, that allows for taller slides too. Let's move our way right up here. We'll take a look at the bathroom in this coach. So as we move in, right here is your foot flush lever toilet. You will notice you have plenty of leg room all the way around. You know, leg room's good, your shoulder room's good. You don't have to worry about bumping into things, which is great. And then right here in front of me is the neo-angle shower. Travel lock on there, just undo that guy. Nice cascade rain doors on there, but plenty of space. You can see the shelving there as well, the hand wand, skylight up top, and again, you know, if you're worried about showers not having enough height, take a look at this. I mean, there is a ton of height in the shower, especially if you're, you know, really tall. I can stand here underneath the skylight. I mean, it's massive in here, so very cool. If you're a taller person, again, this is a great coach. Right up top, you do have a ventilation fan there. Of course, LED lights throughout, ducted AC naturally. Right here, you have a mirrored medicine cabinet with storage behind that. Down below, your sink top and vanity, electrical outlet there, and then you have some additional storage underneath. Now, this bathroom does have two entrances and exits, one into the main living area, the other one into the bedroom. Why don't you come on in, we'll take a look. So as we come into the bedroom, you'll notice the queen size bed here. As I mentioned, we were outside, does have storage underneath and struts to support the bed. Both sides of the bed, I love that you have these giant nightstands here, which is great. You'll also notice you have electrical outlets on both sides too. So whether you need a glass of water up there, or if you want a cell phone to charge, or if you have a CPAP machine, you can go ahead and sleep on either side of the bed, no problem. Then right underneath that, you have the large pull-out full extension drawer here. And then up above is the mirrored wardrobe. You can see the hanging rod going all the way across, and of course you have that on both sides as well. Then right above the in the center here is some extra storage. And again, look how usable this is. You have large storage here. Those big ceilings allow for a bigger storage area in there. Underneath, LED lights in case you want to do a little bit of reading. And if you're one that likes to watch TV, you do have TV hookups right up here, so that way you can watch a show before bed. But all right, folks, that's pretty much going to wrap it up. Again, this is a 2017 Shasta Revere 33BH. If you're looking for a big travel trailer, you know, you want that head height, maybe you're looking to spend a lot of time in it, this is a good one to take a look at. You know, you get those 7-foot ceilings, you have the dual opposing slides in the main living area, slide in the bunk room, so there's plenty of room for everyone here. If you do have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave those in the section below, or you can always give myself, Ian Baker, a call here at American RV, and I'll be happy to answer that way as well. If you do have questions on particular specs of the unit, or if you're looking for latest price and availability, I recommend you visit our website, which is AmericanRV.com, for the most up-to-date information. Also, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe. That way, you'll be one of the first to see new and future content. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and I can't wait to see you on the road to freedom. We'll be right back.